లేట్ రాఘవాచార్య గారు బికాస్ హీ సజెస్టెడ్ సో మెనీ థింగ్స్ టు ద హైదరాబాద్ సిటీ అండ్ అట్ ది సేమ్ టైమ్ ఐ థ్యాంక్ నాగభూషణ్ రావు గారు హిస్ కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఆల్సో ఎనార్మస్ ఇన్ ద ఫీల్డ్ ఆఫ్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్టేషన్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ ఎస్పెషలీ ఫర్ ది హైదరాబాద్ ఐ ఆల్సో థ్యాంక్ మై ప్రొఫెసర్ సూపర్వైజర్ ప్రొఫెసర్ కృష్ణారావు గారు హీ ఆల్సో కాంట్రిబ్యూటింగ్ సో మచ్ టువార్డ్స్ దిస్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్టేషన్ సిస్టమ్స్ క్రియేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ So that is, you know, so many other people also there across the country. But as far as Hyderabad is concerned, the first person, Professor late Raghavachari Garu, then the implementation part, Dr. Nagbhushan Rao Garu, he also contributed in various capacities towards, you know, creation of transportation infrastructure in Hyderabad city. So transportation infrastructure means, so normally is a physical infrastructure, transportation network. So the travel, you know, trip generation process, trip distribution process, then mode choice process, the finally trip assignment process. So this four stage transportation, you know, planning process we normally call. So transportation, these are all, you know, four important aspects. So the transportation, this assignment is nothing but almost you say a physical network. So the physical network consists of, you know, roads, right? And so many other aspects like, you know, the proposals for the, you know, construction of skyways, construction of, you know, skywalks, the roads and metro lines, parking systems and transportation networks and cycle tracks, pedestrian, you know, facilities, etc. These are all comes under the transportation infrastructure. So this transportation infrastructure is not growing according to the demand. So the demand, as I said, is growing almost in a very, very exponential rate. But at the same time, the supply is not, you know, meeting the demand. So always the gap between the demand and supply is increasing maximum extent day by day. So the reasons, obviously, so many reasons will be there. So it's like you know, the policies, especially the government policies is one of the major this thing, and allocation of the budget, and at the same time, integrated planning approach. So integrated transportation planning approach is one of the important aspects for providing transportation infrastructure facilities for any city in general. So unfortunately, the demand is growing and, you know, as I said, the supply is a very, very slower rate, it is increasing. So obviously the impact, so all the systems are saturated now, the load factors are increased at maximum extent, that is more than 3, more than 1.5 sometimes, that again depends upon the city to city. So I request the screen sharing. Just I want to share the screen. Yeah. So if you look at this particular figure, this, you know, title figure. So here, if you look at very clearly, so many things are there. Transportation networks. See, this transportation network, let us say Metro Rail is there, right? Skyways are appearing here. And so many roads are there, right? So one over other. So it's like a, you know, a bigger kind of, you know, transportation infrastructure system. So here, the need of the transportation infrastructure cities is growing day by day. If you look at, if you look at this particular figure. So here, it's like a total transportation infrastructure systems. If you look at this figure, you will understand what exactly meant by transportation infrastructure, you know. So here, if you look at this figure particularly, here air transportation, it is appearing, right? Metro systems are there. Here the metro system, here the metro system, right? Here the skyways are, one skyway is here and another skyway over other, right? And you know, the regular road system, transportation system here, right? So these are all, you know, transportation infrastructure to be created within the available space. That is a major kind of concept. So the cities, obviously all the metropolitan cities and old cities, the space is a serious kind of constraint and serious kind of, you know, challenge. So we cannot create the space. We can create the transportation infrastructure, but we cannot create the space. Space is a limited, that is a challenge. So within the available, you know, land or within the available space, we have to create so many transportation infrastructure, as I said and showed very clearly in this particular one. So accommodating so many things within the available space is a really a tough challenge to any transportation planner or any transportation engineer or any civil engineering in general. So within the available facilities, we have to create so many facilities, transportation infrastructure. This is a bigger challenge. So the space is a serious problem. We cannot expand the roads. Horizontal expansion is no more nowadays. So horizontal expansion no more entertain. Only vertical expansion is only the possibility because of the space constraint. So vertical expansion, if you go to underground to create for creating some kind of transportation infrastructure, it's too costly. So if you go the above ground, sometimes there are certain limitations will be there, and the cost little bit lesser when you compare with the vertical expansion below the ground and above the ground. So many constraints will be there. So a tough challenge to any engineer. Mumbai is facing a serious problem for creation of a metro at certain places underground, certain places above the ground. So even if you look at Delhi, so Delhi almost 90% is above the ground. So there are the problems, different kinds of problems they are facing. So that is the execution and all those. So we are not focusing on the execution part. We are only focusing on planning aspect. Coming to the attributes. So what exactly the causal attributes for the for the system becoming saturation? So one is population is the one of the important aspect. So population is increasing day by day. So we cannot control the population. It's a country policy decision. So within available, our role is as a expert, as a the specialist. Our role is for growing population. What kind of infrastructure is suitable? That is our job. So increase of population is growing with a faster manner, and increase of land use. So land use, if you look at even Hyderabad and any city, the metropolitan regions are expanding like anything. 600 square kilometers area. So increased up to 600 square kilometers and exponentially increasing the land use. So the third aspect, if you look at the motor vehicles, this is another problem. So motor vehicles are increasing, day by day. So every day, almost as per some kind of statistics in Hyderabad, every day 1,000 new vehicles are coming onto the roads. So this is a serious problem. And recently, HMDA conducted a survey, that is CTS, Comprehensive Transportation Study. So if you look at the vehicles, the mode-wise, the 60% of the vehicles are two-wheelers. 60% of the vehicles are two-wheelers. The reason, obviously, the door-to-door transportation everybody expects, especially in Hyderabad, the people are prefer the door-to-door service. So two-wheelers definitely provide door-to-door service. And, another aspect is it's economical. Public transportation only 3%, buses available 3%. So therefore, public transportation, it is not sufficient. Obviously, people will go for the private transportation. So in the private transportation, the two-wheeler is a major one, and contributing more, 60% of the total trips by two-wheelers. And if you look at the businesses, etc., business and trade also increasing. Obviously, the land use, the impact on the land use will be very, very high, and impact on the motor vehicles also very, very high. So if you look at the increase of software jobs, increase of hardware jobs, and private jobs, and educational institutions, so obviously it needs some kind of land use. So land is being utilized for the industries and the software companies and private offices and educational institutions, etc. So obviously, the motor vehicles to commute from one place to other place, obviously to connect from one place to other place, some kind of transportation is required, whether it is a public transportation system, whether it is a private transportation system. So obviously, the number of traffic obviously will increase, and the system will leads to some kind of saturation if the transportation infrastructure is not proper. So as I said, the demand is growing in an exponential manner, but the supply is growing in a very, very slower rate. So this is a serious kind of concern. So we are all experts, and even the governments and even the other stakeholders, they have to look into this aspect. So the supply levels to be increased to match with the growing demand. And coming to the impact, so what happens if the population increases, if the motor vehicles increases, if the land use increases, what happens? So obviously the impact is system normally reaches to the crash point. So when the system reaches to the crash point, the impact on the speeds. So the speeds obviously will come down. So the operating speeds normally in any metropolitan city, it's definitely the level of service will come down. Level of service TC or level of service D, that is 15 to 20 kilometers per hour. In case of peak hour, the 10 kilometers per hour normally, because of this system, reaches to the crash point. So then the peak hour load factor also more than one. So peak hour load factor in certain cities, especially the Mumbai and Delhi, even Hyderabad, the peak hour load factors more than two sometimes. Sometimes it's normally more than one, but peak hours it's more than two. So intermediate public transportation system, if you look at bus load factor, so buses, the capacity is 60, but traveling in the bus is 120. So almost the load factor is more than two. So intermediate public transportation system, if you look at the autos and even seven-seater, etc., the seven-seater name is there, but traveling around 15 to 20 members in the seven-seater. So obviously you can observe. So how much demand is there? So seven-seater allowing 15 to 20 because of compulsion. So even the three-seater auto is allowing five to six members, sometimes even 7 and 8 members also. So the peak, the peak load factor is more than two in even all metropolitan cities. So which results high concentration, means that density is very, very high and the impact is very low, speeds are available on the high roads. So the delays will be very, very high. There is a huge loss on the energy, and at the same time, the pollution levels are increasing day by day, heavy air pollution and noise pollution, which is, not good for the present day and even for the future. So our ultimate job is to reduce all these things by, fulfilling the gap. As I said, the demand versus the supply, when you take into consideration, when you try to reduce the gap, obviously these things will be, improves maximum extent. So as I said, the energy losses we can minimize, because at each signal, so many, hours the vehicles are just stopping, and the every day, if you take into account, that loss for the whole country will be very, very huge. So by creating proper infrastructure, we can reduce this energy losses maximum extent, and at the same time, we can control this, the air pollution and noise pollution maximum extent by just coping up with the demand. The supply levels we have to increase maximum extent. And if you look at this, a simple, information related to metro. So public transportation, everybody, any transportation experts suggest that public transportation is the best one. So to, improve the transportation, comfort or whatever. So public transportation is only the alternative, because the private, transportation, individual vehicles growth is not good. So as I said, the impacts also very clearly. So if you observe this particular, slide, if you take the Shanghai city, so Shanghai city population, almost 2.5 crores of population. I personally visited Shanghai in the year 2013. So the total, the metro system, they built 676 kilometers length of metro network. They constructed totally underground with 413 stations. This is the world highest, 413 stations totally underground. Almost 3 to 4 years time period they took for construction of this 676 kilometers of underground metro. So the efficiency of this metro system also is very, very good in Shanghai. So very, very integrated manner they constructed. They connected two airports, 80 kilometers away, international airports, one airport to other airports. And you can also see the 17 lines, they're operating 17 lines, and they're also serving the annual ride and, the ridership, if you look at 3.71 billion ridership. So number of trips, they're accommodating it by the Shanghai Metro. So if you look at that, the thing is that what I mean to, highlight here is that the population versus the number of kilometers, if you observe. So all the cities mentioned here, 10 cities mentioned here, Moscow, Tokyo, and New York, and, Madrid, Paris, London, etc., all other top cities in the country where the population is, more than 50 lakhs population, right? Maximum 50 lakhs population, and metro length also minimum, the 300 kilometers of metro lengths are there. So as per my you know, observation and analysis, for every 50 lakhs population, at least 200 kilometers of the length of metro is required. So accordingly, for Hyderabad, even other cities, if you look at Indian scenario, if you look at, so upcoming metros, Delhi metro already the two phases completed, that is in now third phase. Till date they completed 348 kilometers, and Mumbai they started just now, the different phases are going on now, they finished only 11.4 kilometers. Like that, all together, all cities, Hyderabad of course 72 kilometers already started this in three routes, right, three lines. So all together 250 kilometers of length of metro constructed till today, another 250 they are planning. But what actually required according to our population, if you look at every 50 lakhs you know population, 200 kilometers of length of metro is required. So based on the you know statistics, so accordingly for Indian cities, all wherever you know more than 50 lakhs of population city is there, it requires now according to my calculation 2500 kilometers of length of metro is required. So that is the demand, but supply is only 500 you know kilometers of length only planned till today. So the gap is 2000 kilometers of length of metro is required for the Indian conditions. So the governments and policy makers and politicians should focus on this for building a excellent sophisticated metro system to cater the you know the citizens of the cities, the citizens who are staying in the city, cities, metropolitan cities. So the personalized vehicles to be you know maximum extent we have to avoid, because everybody expects some kind of you know the number of legs of travel should be minimized. So door to door they expect normally, so we have to facilitate to you know shift from existing mode to the public transportation system to minimize whatever the factors I initially told. So in Indian cities, as far as my knowledge is concerned, 2500 kilometers of public transportation system is definitely needed, because the comfort and everything here, the cost to affordable and affordability and comfort and all aspects metro will fulfill. That is my observation. So across the country, almost 150 top cities they introduced, across the world 150 metro operated cities are there. So everywhere the utility is very good and safety is very good, the you know overall efficiency is excellent in all other 150 cities across the world. In the similar way, in India also, all five major cities and upcoming cities also needs a sophisticated metro system in the Indian system. So as I said, another 200,000 kilometers metro is required. So if you look at this particular diagram, particular photo, is the overcrowding. If you look at the demand, so it shows the demand. Here, according to the standards, in 1 square meter area in any public transportation system, 4 to 5 members can stand. 4 to 5 members can stand comfortably in 1 square meter area. According to the statistics, 4 to 5 members can stand comfortably. So here, if you look at this diagram, this picture from Mumbai local train, you know, here for 1 square meter area, 18 to 25 members are standing. So you can observe the demand here. So the demand is almost 5 times more than the you know the required. So as per the standards, 4 to 5 members can stand comfortably, but here 18 to almost 25 members standing in 1 square meter area. So our job is to reduce this particular you know the high demand 5 folds to again 1 fold. It is not the easy job. Overnight we cannot create. So some kind of long term planning is required. At least to another 30 years we have to keep to bring out from 5 folds to is at least this a 1 fold according to the standards. So this is a major challenge. So this is a great challenge to the transportation specialists and experts and even the governments also. So coming to this particular traffic jam, so here also if you look at this, so many vehicles, so many different kinds of you know modes, different kinds of vehicles, it's a totally jam packed. So here supposed to travel according to the you know the according to the you know 2-lane and 3-lane highway capacity, so 2000 per lane or maximum 2000 per lane like that. So here if you look at here, definitely it is more than you know 3,000 vehicles per lane. Of course, there is no movement at all because the speeds are very, very low. It is very difficult to accommodate because the capacity is very low, but volume very high. Obviously, the impact is the level of service will be very, very poor. So when the level of service is very, very poor, we cannot expect the high speeds. So the comfort levels and speed and satisfaction of the user will be very, very, unhappy. So our job is to, we have to shift from this is a demand, and we have to shift from this state to and this state. So here I am just changing the slide. So from this state to this state, it's only 1 second, even less than half second or 1/4 second. But to creation of such kind of infrastructure, at least it needs 50 years. So 50 years time period it needs to transform from this state to this state. So this is a major challenge in front of all, the Indian transportation experts, as well as, the policymakers and governments. And similarly, if you look at this diagram, so here is the demand is very, very high. So this is a problem. This is a problem. And, this is the solution. So everybody expect such kind of public transportation system. So this is like a metro system, because the comfortable, as I said, people from compulsion to they're moving towards compulsion to this comfort. So in this process, everybody expecting AC buses, everybody expecting AC environment. So we have to provide according to the user requirement. So that is the job of any transportation expert. So coming to this particular aspect, so this is a solution for the whatever the figure I showed. This is a problem, and this is the solution. So to transform from that state to this state, at least as I said, the 50 years long term planning is required with a lot of commitment and allocation of the budget, and keenly working on the master plan to be prepared to transform from the existing state to the future state. So this is a real kind of challenge. And if you look at as I said, this is a problem and this is a solution, but the time period is 50 years here. Time period is 15 years. Money required is very, very, very huge here. So the so many inputs required, the government's commitment, policies, it's not that much easy to change from this state to this state. So this is a greater kind of challenge. So therefore, some kind of the proper kind of integrated kind of planning is very, very essential for providing such kind of facility. If you look at so sometimes we feel that some kind of viaduct or skyways gives proper solution. So as far as my opinion is concerned, the creation of infrastructure is one aspect, but the maintenance of infrastructure and managing traffic management is another one. So simply creation of infrastructure is one aspect, and at the same time, on the created infrastructure, the operation of traffic management is another aspect, is another challenge. So what I actually felt is, here if you look at here, the world longest traffic jam in the Beijing, almost 100 kilometers long, 100 kilometers long. It took sometimes, I think long back, 11 days to clear this traffic. So because of improper traffic management on the created infrastructure creates so many problems. So all the time, the creation of infrastructure is not the solution, but after creation of infrastructure, we have to maintain or manage the traffic in the sophisticated manner. So that is also one of the important aspect one has to, follow. So coming to, the modes, design of modes. So here, this is a double-decker train. I captured this particular figure in Sydney, in Australia. It's a local train, Sydney local train. So here they introduced, double-decker trains. So instead of a single-decker train, the capacity is single-decker train is very low. And if you just accommodate 1.5 meter, the height, if you increase for the mode, you can create, double-decker, and you can increase the capacity two folds here, maximum extent. So by doing so, by inventing small things or innovatively introducing small things, you can accommodate more number by changing, the physical, size of the compartment. So this is another kind of, what you call this alternative for accommodating more people in the local trains. So as far as my knowledge is concerned, long back in Mumbai also they started, you know, AC trains. But the AC trains, you know, only it accommodates maximum 2,000 per, you know, one total train, 11 coaches. But wherein the present situation in one train, around 11 coaches, almost 4,000 to 5,000 people are traveling. As I just shown that figure, that is, you know, one square meter area, 20 to almost 18 to 25 members is traveling. That facility may not be available in the case of AC trains. So they experimented and they stopped the AC trains because, so every time almost, you know, in AC 2000 and minus this 5,000, so almost 3,000 members remains at the stations only because of AC, AC and not permitting standing as per the earlier. So these are all, you know, various innovative things. If you plan in the different way, so obviously we can accommodate more number of, you know, people in the trains. And if you look at the transportation infrastructure, as I said, you know, the creation of transportation infrastructure in the traditional way and smart way of creation of infrastructure. So any infrastructure, it should attract the, you know, users. So just aesthetics also one of the important aspect when you go for the creation of transportation infrastructure. Whether it is, you know, a flyover, whether it is a, you know, skyway or some kind of infrastructure, it should be, you know, very, very aesthetically good. So therefore, the utility rate normally will increase when you create that too innovative manner. You have to plan, not routine way. In an innovative manner, we have to create the infrastructure. That is a major challenge in front of transportation engineers and civil engineers. If you look at these all diagrams, a different kinds of, you know, infrastructure and aesthetics involved here. And coming to these airports, even airports also to be created, you know, the infrastructure to be created in a very, very innovative manner, and efficiency should be increased to maximum extent and multi-purpose. So if you look at Heathrow Airport, at a time six flights take off normally takes place at a place, the six flights, you know, landing will take place in such a manner, sophisticated manner they constructed the airport. And the operations also very easy in a very, 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 you know, space. The space also they utilized, you know, accord very optimum manner. So the space is a serious problem for any city. So within the available space, you have to accommodate more number of features and see that the efficiency of system to be improved maximum extent. And of course, docks and harbors. These are all, you know, transportation infrastructure only. These are all, you know, if you look at this, all flyovers, etc. Yeah. So another important aspect, the roads also comes under the transportation infrastructure, roads also. So the construction of a road is not sufficient. So until unless if you provide, you know, all the operational related things, guidance related things, like, you know, the traffic, what you call these lanes, the markings, signals, etc. is very, very important. So recently I received a WhatsApp message. So in the Kerala, the safe corridor they constructed. So they allocated crores of money for creation of the safe corridors by providing all the lanes. And sometimes, you know, curved lanes also they provided. It means that some extra safety to be taken care by the driver. So recently, Professor Veera Raghavan forwarded that message. So one corridor they selected as a safe kind of corridor by experimentally they introduced all the, you know, ideal conditions of transportation infrastructure, including everything, all safety measures, including, you know, providing signals and even sign convention and even, you know, road markings, etc. They prepared that road in a very, very ideal way, and they are also studying the accident rate even after creation of this, all these things. So how the people, you know, using that particular smart infrastructure, so where the problems are coming, they are planning to study. So like that, the simply construction of any road, simply construction of any infrastructure not sufficient. So some kind of, you know, the all you know, the sign conventions and even road markings, etc. to be followed as per the Indian Roads Congress or any other specification. So then only we can minimize the accidents, and we can increase the safety, and we can increase the efficiency, and obviously we can instruct the users to follow as per the norms. And another important thing is the smart infrastructure, as I said. So this photograph I took in the Germany in small city, that is Aachen city. So the footover bridge, they simply constructed multi-purpose footover bridge, not only this one. So the pedestrian, they can move from one place to other place. And at the same time, bicycles also they can use. Simple suspension, this footover bridge they constructed, this is some kind of innovative. So the structural engineer also should think in a very innovative manner for creation of such kind of simple structure. They can cross this road from one place to other way, and it is connected to this footpath. Simply, it's like an access to the pedestrian. Straight away, you can use this particular structure, and you can cross the road in a very, very safe and efficient manner. And not only that, even they can use the bicycles also. So in such a manner, there is no similarity of one structure to other structure in other countries. So our engineers also should, focus on that. So in a innovative manner, they have to create the smart infrastructure so that everybody. So here utility rate is 99% utility rate. So the difference between the other countries and our place. Example, I'll give one small example. Long back, I don't know whether it is correct or not. Long back, 20 years, 25 years back, at RTC crossroad, they constructed the subway. So today that subway is closed. And at the same time, at Koti, one subway they constructed by spending some crores of rupees. So today it is not in operational mode. So why it is not operational mode? So who is behind these? All these things if we question. See, my point is here, I'm not questioning the authorities. Here, that facility is not being utilized today because of somebody's fault. So the space is wasting, the infrastructure is wasted, the money wasted, all the resources wasted. So instead of creating such kind of, infrastructure without considering the user perception. User perception also very, very important here when you go for such a huge infrastructure facility in any city. So what user normally thinking? The simple, comparison I'll tell. In India, so 5 metropolitan cities are there, but the people behavior from one place to other place, it is changing. So if you look at Mumbai Chhatrapati Shivaji terminus. So once the local train, they're out from the local train, 99% of these passengers, they're using the subway, 99%. 1% less than 1%, they're using just road, they're crossing road. But at the same time, in our place, the subway, the percentage of utility is very, 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 very nominal. So everybody want to cross just across the road. They don't want to use the footover bridges or subways. So the behavior is a serious kind of concern. So what is wrong in the Hyderabad people? What is wrong in Mumbai people? What is wrong in the, Delhi people? The behavioral aspects also taken into consideration. Behavioral aspect is very, very important. And another aspect is enforcement also very, very important. And education or utilization of a smart infrastructure also very, very important. So we have to facilitate more number of, such kind of infrastructure to cross the road from one place to other place. This is a serious kind of a challenge to any transportation expert. Of course, advanced technologies are there. Today, the world is moving with the technology. Right. And now the seminar also conducting using technology because of compulsion, because of, Corona 19, COVID-19. So unfortunately, so technology no doubt is going in a very, very exponential manner, growing in a very, very exponential manner. And we have to catch up the technology. So GIS technology is there, GPS technology is there, and some other technology is there. We have to utilize the technology for the, for operational purpose, maximum extent. So planning purpose and construction design purpose, at the same time operational purpose also, to enhance the efficiency of the system, the technologies are very, very important. Of course, this advanced travel information system, now we are using in Hyderabad metro also, everywhere across the world, 150 top cities, metro cities, they are using this advanced technology. Now world is flat, technology somewhere means introduced, renovated, means that is transferred to any place. Now world is flat. World is now became the global village, right? corona, that is why just world is flat, reached everywhere, very simply. So the another important aspect is we are neglecting the non-motorized, non-motorized transportation system. So everybody preferring the motorized transportation system. If you look at the top cities in the world, especially United States of America, European countries, even the Japan and even Australia. So I personally visited and observed that everywhere they are giving top priority for the, pedestrian crosswalks. In, San Francisco, I observed 10 to 15 meters width of, the pedestrian, pedestrian path, that is footpath, 10 to 15 meters. I'm not joking. This is there in San Francisco. Even in the Chicago also, I observed 5 to 8 meters of pedestrian paths. So the user, the planner, they have to, the planning agencies, they have to take care of this aspect. So today, unfortunately, all our Indian cities, are very, very congested. In especially Hyderabad city, it is very difficult to plan now the pedestrian paths, even cycle path. In the United States of America and other cities, the demand actuated signals are there. So the pedestrians are, more to cross the road. They can just switch on that button and they can cross. So even cyclists also, there are separate cycle paths also they created in the city. In the London city, I visited. London is one of the beautiful city, and all the transportation systems they are following perfectly, and very compatible or very smooth way of they provided the pedestrian footpaths and cycle paths in a very, very decent manner in the London. Plus London Metro, one of the beautiful, it is one of the top metro. And the three levels of underground metro they constructed, and their fare policy is also very excellent. Even for every 1 kilometer in any direction. So if you go to north direction, if you go to south direction, east and west direction, you will get the metro station. So that is why even the very rich people also they use the metro system. So the utility rate almost the London people, 80% of the population, they use the metro for the regular purpose, and even the job purpose, they use the metro. Only once in a while for the going out, they use their personal cars. Otherwise, London Metro is one of a comfortable kind of metro. They plan it in a very, 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 accessible, very accessible. So it's a square grid type of metro they planned underground totally. It is very difficult to provide a below one level construction is very difficult, but they provided three levels. So intercity, intercountry, like that, intercity, intercountry, and, intracity. So three levels they constructed in the London. So that is one of the state-of-the-art, technology they used. And London Metro, very, very, very successfully running. The utility rate also very, very high. Occupancy ratio also very, very high. And people, more than 80% they are using. So in Indian cities, unfortunately, the non-motorized vehicles totally neglected. And we were not encouraging this. And because of negligence of these non-motorized vehicles, the pollution levels are increasing, noise pollution and air pollution. So one has to, focus on this particular kind of aspect. This is a very important area. So then the public transportation system, of course, if you look at this bus, so the capacity is also we can increase wherever possible by providing these long buses. So instead of 60, we can accommodate 150. And at the same time, if you look at very keenly this particular photograph, and here this is the bus stop. This is the bus stop here wrote with the letters in this. I took this photograph from London. So here the footpaths. So they stopped the vehicle just besides the footpath. So one when get down very comfortably, their leg foot, they can comfortably put on the footpath. In such a manner, they created the infrastructure. So this is a very small point, but that small point also they considered for providing of the footpath. So this is very, very important. We cannot neglect simple things. So simple things also very, very important. So when you give such kind of safety and comfortable assurance to the user, so obviously the patronage will increase to the public transportation this system. So the planner should think so at ground level so that it is possible to implement each and every system according to the user perception, not the planner perception. So planner perception is planner view, but user perception always you have to think of. That is more important. In the Indian cities also, unfortunately, what happening, the user perception point of view, many people not thinking. That is a serious kind of concern. So one has to think in the user perception point of view we have to provide or design or plan the transportation infrastructure system. And another important aspect is monorail system. So all the CBD areas, downtown areas, even if you look at, you know, the other cities like Sydney and even United States of America, many cities, they connected all the hotels and even all shopping malls, etc., using this monorail system. They are discouraging all the cars not to enter into CBD. So in Sydney area, the car parking cost is really very, very high. So the parking cost for 1 year in CBD area is more than the car cost. So not only Sydney, even the Tokyo also. So Tokyo also, the population wise is very, very, very high. And Tokyo, they constructed airport 80 kilometers away, away from the Tokyo CBD area. But 80 kilometers, they're traveling within 30 minutes. So the rapid, you know, train system they introduced. So rapid train system they introduced just to 30 from CBD area, local train, one station junction to that Narita airport, almost 30, 80 kilometers away, efficient public transportation system is there. So any city, when they construct a airport, so first of all, they have to start the public transportation system. So efficient metro system, that is very much essential. So after inaugurating, after starting up that metro system or public transportation system, then only any kind of, you know, airport or any kind of, you know, operation normally should start. So one has to follow. Even ICAO also suggests that if any city construct, you know, any airport 30 kilometers away from the city, so one has to ensure that public transportation is a must according to ICAO guidelines, Indian International Civil Aviation Organization, Montreal. So this is a serious kind of aspect. So the monorail system also, CBD area, when you not allow the public transportation cars to the CBD area, when you encourage the metro system, so a person residing just at suburb area or other than CBD area, they can catch up the metro, they can get down in the CBD area. In the CBD area, monorail system with 3 kilometers radius, 5 kilometers radius, 10 kilometers radius, like that, all the busy business areas and commercial areas and even the other important areas should be connected with the monorail system. So monorail is a simple kind of system. They can get down any place according to their will and wish. So this is another kind of, you know, alternative for the public transport, for public transportation, especially in the CBD areas, downtown areas. Of course, creation of the infrastructure, as I said, you know, it's a huge escalator at railway station. So it's at a time, almost 200 members can utilize at a time. So it is continuous kind of process. In London Metro, the beauty is within 3 minutes, you can reach to any platform, three level, level one, level two, level three, like that. Within three minutes, you can reach to any place. So huge escalators are there and huge, you know, lifts also provided in the London Metro. So the thing is that even in the emergency also, the so many other, you know, the infrastructure facilities they created, there is no single minute, even single second power loss in the metro stations, especially in other countries. So coming to the public transportation system operation, the driver's conductor system is not there in majority of the countries. But in India, as I said, you know, because the demand is very high and, you know, peak hour load factor is more than 3, obviously without conductor, it is very, very difficult to operate. So conductorless this public transportation system in all other countries. But when you lower the demand or otherwise you reaching this supply level maximum extent, such kind of system is possible in even in the Indian metropolitan cities also. And another important area in the metropolitan cities is parking. So there is no much importance for the parking, especially in the metropolitan cities. You take any city, Mumbai, they constructed off-street parking maximum extent many places. Even Delhi also, they constructed some off-street parking systems. But in Hyderabad and other areas, the off-street parking system is very, very limited. As per my knowledge, 1 or 2 off-street parking systems are there in Hyderabad. And if you look at, you know, if you look at any vehicle, any car, so the car, you know, in the life, 15 years life, only 4% of 15 years life, 4% in the moment, and rest of the 96%, rest of the 96% in the lifetime of the car is still parking somewhere. So that may be at home, that may be at office, that may be at shopping, that may be at commercial place, that may be somewhere else. So therefore, 96% or 94% of the parking that is at a stopwood stage only. Therefore, one can understand the need of the parking. So need of the parking is very much essential even in the metropolitan cities of Indian cities. So now the planner should focus on this, the parking system also, very, very important. And there are certain policies also we have to evolve with the parking system. Parking, you know, the free parking, we have to discourage. So the paid parking system should be every parking minute, parking hour to be taken into consideration. Okay, even in the public transportation, even in the public parking or private parking, off-street parking and on-street parking, etc. So then coming to the one example I'll show, when I visited Chicago, the United States of America, in CBD area near the Reconnaissance Hotel. So two exclusive buildings constructed for the off-street parking, exclusive buildings constructed for the, it's a great kind of infrastructure. So 33 floors, each building consists of 33 floors exclusively for the car parking. So it's an amazing kind of, you know, decision taken by the, you know, Chicago metropolitan, this region development. So like that, even in the Indian cities also, this is the need of the hour. One should focus on the exclusive parking system in the metropolitan cities. You can also see the observe, the close-up picture of this, you know, car parking system. So how cars are parked in a beautiful manner. So mechanical parking system they introduced, If you just leave your car at the entrance, your car will be parked at any floor in 4 or 5 minutes. And besides this particular building, the metro station is there. So the walking time from this particular gate of this parking system to reach the metro station within 3 minutes. It's a walkable. In such a manner, they integrated. So integrated the system. So integrated system very much important, because you know that walking time or shifting time from one mode to other mode, it should not take more than 3 minutes. So if it is more than 3 minutes or more than 5 minutes, obviously the people, they are reluctant to use the public transportation system. So the people, they are coming to, you know, they're parking the system simply, they're dropping the car, they're catching the public transportation system, that is metro, and they're completing job, that they're coming back, they're giving some message, universal, you know, travel information system, like, you know, technology they are using. So that the car will be ready when he reach to the particular gate. So like that, they made this all car parking and even operation very, very simplified, so that the user is very, very happy to use such kind of systems. So coming to the smart infrastructure, as I said, so pedestrian infrastructure is one of the important aspect in the metropolitan cities. It's a real challenge. So unfortunately, I don't know, you know, the slim structures are very, very, very preferable. Slim structures. So slim structure aesthetically good and strength-wise also should be good in such a kind of infrastructure to be created. If you look at this particular pedestrian, you know, the footover bridge. So here, just if you observe very clearly, this particular tower, a simple tower, the two sides glass is provided here. So this is a lift. This is a lift. Lift can be used for the, you know, children as well as old age, more than 60. And safety point of view also, you know, the glasses they provided, transparent glasses provided, the either side, two sides. And only two sides, the structure is there. So the total particular subway structure is totally, you know, resting on two tall towers. The material used here is smart material, nano material, right? So people can use without any kind of, you know, hesitations. Highest safety is there. So this is simply suspended kind of, you know, a circular structure, right, which accommodates safe crossing of people from one place to other place without any kind of hesitation. It's a challenge to the structural engineer also for designing such a complicated structure. It's a simple structure, but complicated design. So it's a innovative kind of thing. So obviously the people will use. So when you look at it, the aesthetic appearance, safety, and lift, even steps also, if you look at the steps here, only 30 degrees angle, only 30 degrees angle is here, steps, 30 degrees. So one can climb very easily, school going children, even old age also, they can also use alternative method like lift also provided. So such kind of transportation, you know, the pedestrian infrastructure should be provided in Indian, you know, metropolitan cities, so that the utility rate will be very, very high. My intention is the utility. Utility is one of the important aspects. So coming to the other aspects, like, you know, the transportation, of course, the junctions, when you take the junctions, right, this is one of the top junction in the world, that is the Judge Harry, the Pregerson intersection, okay, that is between interstates in the Los Angeles. So it's like a totally confusing, right? So many, one over other, planning such a beautiful, you know, huge kind of intersection is not an easy thing. So many minds, you know, worked on this particular, you know, intersection. Here, everybody requires, total civil engineering is required here. So structural engineering required, transportation, traffic, planning, right, geotechnical engineering, even concrete specialists like that. It's a total teamwork of civil engineering. So it's an operational now. So planning itself is a serious kind of thing, and implementation and even successfully operating things, that is traffic management, very efficient traffic management. This is a serious challenge in the metropolitan cities. As I said, you know, construction of the transportation infrastructure is one aspect, and operation on that, it's a real challenge by using the technology. So this is very, very, very the important area for the any metropolitan cities while providing the transportation infrastructure. And if you look at this particular picture, which I took in the China, Shanghai, normally when you build the, you know, bridge, so bridge means connecting, you know, two banks of a river or something, some stream. This is a general concept of any structural engineer or any planner. But here they constructed this particular structure. So already, you know, some kind of, you know, existing houses and existing, you know, buildings are there. So with the minimum damage of the building or minimum vacating of the infrastructure, existing buildings or place, they constructed in a very, very, very innovative manner. So only 30% of this land they utilized. They dismantled the structures, existing one, and they constructed the beautiful, you know, spiral infrastructure, that is intersection. So how beautifully they constructed. So one should think in an innovative manner, not routine. So traditionally, when you construct, so nobody means appreciates, and nobody, the utility, everything will come down. So when you think in a very innovative manner, optimum manner, right, obviously people will appreciate, and utility also will increase maximum extent, and without affecting the existing, what you call the infrastructure or buildings, whatever. So one can think about the in an innovative manner. Of course, these are all such kind of infrastructure. So this is one of the, you know, important aspect, you know, the transportation, you know, one of the, you know, transportation highway is passing through building. So road is coming to the building, see, through building. This is one of the, again, another important kind of, you know, because space is a problem. At ground level, space is a problem. So therefore, the people are going for the providing, you know, the skyways in the different ways. So now they're creating the space in the, on the, you know, not on the, you know, exactly means a land. So they are creating the different kinds of, you know, levels, okay, in the air. So connecting through buildings and other things in a very integrated manner and innovative manner. So one should think in the different way. So the innovative thinking is very, very much essential. And coming to this airport, so the Beijing, one of the top international airport, Beijing, if you look at this particular diagram, here the below, you know, ground level, if you look at the ground level, the highway is passing below this runway. So the space they are utilizing for multi-way, multi-purpose, even in the Paris also, the metro lines are just going below the, you know, runway or airport, and even the highways also just passing through below the ground. And here also the space is utilized multi-purpose. So multi-purpose utilization of space in the metropolitan cities, very much essential in the present day context, because we cannot create the land. So we cannot create the space. Only we have to go in a vertical manner. So if possible, level one, level two, level three below, and if possible, above the ground, level one, level two, level three, like that. Only thing is that constraint, the budget and proper planning, integrated planning is innovative planning, and accommodating so many within the available space. That is the optimum way planning is very much essential in the present day context. Of course, the another important aspect is pedestrian movement at the junctions. So if you look at it, even in the Hyderabad also, the LB Nagar, Uppal and major junctions like, you know, Medipatnam, the skywalks, one should think about the skywalks. This is the need of the hour. So because, you know, the demand is growing. So many, you know, inconveniences and time lapse and even consumption of time and accidents and safety, the pedestrian should feel all the time safe and comfortable. So therefore, comfortable and safe infrastructure we have to provide. So here, if you look at, this is also I captured from the China. So if you look at this particular one, the shopping complexes to shopping complex and some kind of commercial complexes to directly, they can, you know, cross the road without any kind of interruption. So here the utility rate also 90%. So these kind of structures also in the Indian cities very much essential. One should plan in such a manner to, you know, provide a sophisticated facility to the users. Of course, there are, like, you know, as I said, the transportation problems. Now I showed all the transportation problems and right and some kind of ways also. So here, if you look at, you know, the problems point of view, transportation problems point of view, I think chairman sir, time 1 hour I said.
One hour I said, sir.
Oh, shall I continue for with your permission?
Okay, sir, you can continue.
Another 5-10 minutes.
Okay, sir, please.
Okay. So transportation problems overall, if you look at, so there are certain service problems, right? And certain problems like, you know, those in problems domain that affected by transportation. So because of transportation, what are the impacts? And by providing transportation, what are the impacts? And what are the service problems? So any transportation specialist, one should understand about the service problems. And when you introduce the new systems, what is the impact? And, you know, after introducing of, you know, otherwise, what are the factors to force to create the new infrastructure? If you look at, you know, the outer ring road, Hyderabad, 165 kilometers length of outer ring road they constructed. So some purpose will be there. So what are the various, you know, the factors motivated to go for the outer ring road? So after construction of the outer ring, what is the impact against society? So so many impacts will be there after creation of the, so before metro and after metro. So what factors motivated to go for the metro, and even after completion of the metro, what are the impacts? So like that. So one should understand these things in a very, very keen manner, and then service problems. So service problems are plenty. I am not going to focus on that. So congestion and all, you know, the high user cost, as I said, like, you know, safety and even the pollution, etc., like that. So of course, ultimately, the traffic stream parameters comes into picture. One is, you know, the efficiency of the system normally measured in terms of speed efficiency. So any efficiency normally measured in terms of speed. So when the infrastructure accommodates higher speeds or designated speeds, so it means that the infrastructure is sufficient, right? Sufficient and meeting the demand, right? So otherwise, what happens when the speeds are available, speeds are very low, so it means that the infrastructure is very, very poor. So we have to think about the value of time. This is value of travel time is very, very important. So value of travel time for the, you know, city to city, it varies. If you look at Indian cities 5, the Mumbai is having highest value of travel time, and then the Delhi is having highest travel time. So like that, Bangalore and then Madras, Hyderabad, like that. So any international company, so normally they come for creation of the infrastructure based on the value of travel time. Because when you assure the returns, so obviously the value of travel time, when it is high, the many transportation infrastructure, the projects will come for that city because the repaying capacity, it is like a repaying capacity. So Mumbai is having highest value of travel time. That is why the many companies coming forward, and even the planners also or politicians also, they're taking decision for the investing more money towards the transportation infrastructure creation. So as I said, the speed is one of the important one, you know, measure of this quality. So speed is indicates the infrastructure. If the speeds prevailing on the roads or transportation infrastructure according to the design, it means that it's a good kind of infrastructure. Of course, the challenges, as I said, many challenges are there. I showed, you know, transformation from existing state to other one. the important challenge is human behavior. Understanding human behavior very, 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 very important, especially related to transportation. So driver, pedestrian, user, passenger. So their behavior, see, one person, if you look at a person walking on the pedestrian, his behavior will be different. A person just driving two wheeler, his behavior will be different. A person driving a car or sitting in the car, his behavior will be different. A person traveling in a bus, his behavior is different. So person is same, but is behaving differently at different places. So this is called a behavioral modeling. See, one should understand about the behavior. So without understanding the behavior or without taking the feedback of the users, when you provide or when you create the transportation infrastructure, the impact on the utility will be very, very high. So then coming to the estimation of size of the problem. So we are saying simply size, the problems, problem. So the one should understand the depth, the length and the breadth of the problem, very, very important. Because once you know the problem, it's a big problem, as I said. So transforming from existing state to, the actual ideal state, it takes 50 years. So it's a big problem. The size of the problem is very, very high. So for this, it needs a lot of money, lot many experts, right? And, the policy makers. So like that, to solve that problem, it takes a lot of time. So problems are classified into, the bigger size problems, intermediate problems, and like small problems. So small problems, the probability of completion of small problems, definitely 90%. The intermediate problems, 50-50%. The bigger problems. So that is master plan. When you go for 30 years, 50 years master plan, the probability of completion is, especially in the like developing countries context, because of the economy, so the probability will be very, very low. Only 50%, less than 50% for the long-term projects. So when you plan for 30 years, 40 years like that. So then, the environmental impact assessment is very, very important. So Bandravalli Sea Link, they constructed a bigger bridge, right? So the clearance, taking off a environmental impact without damaging to the environment, we have to create the transportation infrastructure. This is very, very important aspect. Even next is choice of technology. What kind of technology we have to use? For example, underground metro. So underground metro tunnel, digging of tunnel. If you use, a traditional kind of way, it takes time. So example I gave, Shanghai Metro, they constructed almost 3 to 3.5-4 years period, almost 600 plus kilometers of metro. So sophisticated technology, they use it for digging of a tunnel. So like that, the choice of technology, not only machinery point of view, even any kind of, software point of view and some other point of view, the recent, the technology we have to use, of course, it is related to the cost also. And the squeezing space problem. So as I said, vertical expansion is only the correct kind of thing, but horizontal expansion is a not at all suggested one. So if you ask any transportation professional in this world, they normally, until unless the space is available in the metropolitan cities, space is a serious problem. So therefore, they always prefer for the going vertical, not horizontal. Of course, in the system, you have to think in a multi-objective manner. When you propose something, it should fulfill, it should serve so many things, multi-objective, anything should be multi-objective, and so many criterias, like multi-criteria. So minimization, maximization, like that, the criteria also you have to, then the multi-spectral, it should cover everything, right? In such a manner, you have to go for the, the transportation, the systems. So the another thing is, as I said, policy makers and even politicians, governments also, they should be, very keen in providing the transportation infrastructures. Of course, the other system components also one should take care, like, the value-based systems. So we have to create the value-based systems, like, the good, bad, etc. Definitely, when you create some facility, good, bad will be there. So as I said, RTC crossroad is one of subway. So people, they created, but the ultimate this thing is bad. So they are not using right now. So like that, when you go for a creation of a top infrastructure, definitely you have to always win the user's opinion. Then criteria. So the criteria is also whether you have to minimize, maximize. These are all very, very important. The another important aspect is measure of effectiveness and measure of collectiveness. So when you create a transportation infrastructure, everybody, the measure of effectiveness, how effectively, people are using, how effectiveness, right? and measure of collective means revenue. So how much revenue you are getting by creating such kind of such a infrastructure, right? Well, metro we created. So metro comes under PPP project. So the revenue measure of collective is very good. The effectiveness also very good. When the effectiveness is very good, the collectiveness also very good. There is a relationship between effectiveness versus the collectiveness. So one should create infrastructure for the, you know, in a very, very effective way in user point of view. So obviously user also, he never hesitate to use that, and willingness to pay also increases. So that revenue also increases. Yeah, of course, these are all some of the transportation projects across the, you know, country. Delhi Metro is one of the, of course, different phases like that. So many transportation infrastructure projects are going on across the country, across the world. Of course, transportation, so many organizations are there in India for the benefit of, you know, participants, all listed here, this worldwide. So these are all, you know, thank you very much for patiently listening, because time said 1 hour. That is why just I covered little faster manner. If you have any questions and any clarifications, you are welcome to ask. From my side, I'll try to satisfy maximum extent as per my knowledge. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. Thank you once again. Yeah, please, sir.
Good evening, Kumar sir. Very happy. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Sorry, I'm not able to proper introduction. You are having a lot of lengthy resume. I think MN Professor and would be Vice Chancellor sir. I traveled from AG office to here, so for the Chelepina, happy.
Sir,
as you said, congratulations with the permission of our chair, Commissioner Garu and Honorable Secretary Garu.
Thank you, sir.
One Garuda bus introduction to Hyderabad to Vijayawada.
Yeah.
So there is only one stop Suryapet.
Okay.
I requested the MD and chairman, then the chairman, they immediately agreed to stop at Kodada. Because okay, Kodada is a cosmopolitan town having a lot of industries like cement factories, everybody is traveling by, all the groups, they agreed. But while taking turn to National Highway to bus stop of the Kodada depot, what do you call the plate? Just now you showed in the PowerPoint presentation, the plate was continually damaged. And next they are cancelled. Ante akinda unna tires racks are all down undi highway ku no bus stop lo.
Okay.
So aa vidhanga sir mee cheppinattu RTC crossroads, Koti, subways also closed. It is a very sad thing. Every city should have town planning undal sir. I did MERP, Master of Urban Regional Planning in JNTU first batch. Vallu town planning cities ante mana towns anni ippudu except Chandigarh and Mysore tappa migila towns anni edithune kabatti is highway project sir. Very happy. Yeah. Thanks, Kumar sir. Mem proposal enduku chala baagu chepparu. Again, we are planning after the corona, we will conduct with our chairman sir and secretary sir and eminent Nagaraja sir, Satra sir, vala parinchukoni malli peddaga pettaalsi avasaram undi. Because transport, we are given very good power plant for Delhi and all these things.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. This is one, and of course, so you said now that is intercity, that comes under intercity travel.
Yes, sir.
Because Hyderabad to Vijayawada, that is another topic. So yes. I can also talk on that. I'll give one more lecture on that. Okay, intercity travel. Right? Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you very much, sir.
Kumar garu, I have a session for you.
Satyanarayana sir, maatladutanta. Satyanarayana sir, maatladi sir.
Session for you.
Please.
Sir, you know, it's the Usmani University. Today, you are the principal of the engineering college.
Yeah, yeah, sir.
Sir, you know, I just want to suggest you, you know, like our, Infosys at Mysore. Can we make only cycle, you know, cycle ride within the campus of our Usmani University?
Non-motor. Yes, sir. 100%, sir. But only the problem is that decision making. See, everything is possible.
You are the decision maker and you are also very close to the
VC, sir.
Vice Chancellor.
Sir, actually, the problem is, you know, Usmani University is located in center of the, you know, city, and all the sites, you know, all residential colonies are there. So the access, you know, when you access free, totally anybody can come at any time. There is no access control. That is a serious kind of problem. And university also facing same thing. So the for students, we can, you know, we can instruct the students for usage of these cycles, But the problem is there are again some students, you know, non-border issue is there, and some other, you know, they won't listen sometimes, you know, some kind of edemancy and other things. But maximum extent we can, the thing is that majority of the hostels very near to the colleges. For example, if you look at engineering college. So engineering college just within five minutes, they can reach by walk, within 5 minutes. So girls hostel and boys hostel. So like that, hostels are very, very near, and majority of the students, they walk, those who are staying in the hostels. So they can use cycles. If they want to go to arts college or some other administrative building, they can use these bicycles. Only thing is, at higher level, we have to introduce this non-motorized, decision.
No, today, why I'm telling you is today...
At a higher level. To our,
a bureaucrat is a VC, not an academician.
Yeah.
Always take the decisions and help you to implement this kind of systems. It is only session. Very much.
Yeah, definitely, sir. But the only thing is, you know, the students, they have to come with their own, wholeheartedly for usage of bicycles, skills, right? So we cannot insist sometimes, because if you insist, no, again, they'll make some kind of, some kind of nuisance.
Yeah, yeah. That's the problem. That is where your administration, you have to counsel them.
Sure, sir. But I'll try maximum extent. I'll focus this issue and I'll bring it to the notice of our honorable in charge vice chancellor and principal secretary, municipal administration, definitely.
Also in charge, correct, sir.
Thank you very much.
Sir, now,
Shyam Prasad Reddy garu.
Please.
Hello, hearty congratulations, Kumar garu. Really wonderful, effective presentation and transportation. Incidentally, my project work in BE was a transportation only.
Oh, great, sir. Great coincidence.
after 45 years, I am hearing a lecture and again a transportation.
It's a great opportunity to me, sir.
Start for transportation.
One thing I want to propose, one proposal, yeah. You see, in the present scenario of COVID-19, how do you propose the public transportation? You see, real metro, they are not able to...
actually, sir, only thing is, we have to take a lot of precautions, sir. We can open the public transportation system, but only thing is that, especially metro, this lot of sanitization process we have to involve at the, beginning and even end of the travel, and even... during the travel also, a lot of, sanitation is required. So that sanitation cost will be little high. So if the government's ready to, metro, this metro, Hyderabad Metro Rail Corporation, if they're ready to, bear that money, so obviously people will come. Sir. We have to give assurance to the users. We have to give the assurance to the users regarding this sanitization, right? And healthy and clean environment.
How about the buses, local?
Buses very difficult, sir, because it's uncontrollable variable, because the people just like that, they get into bus and even the crowd, as I said, so the peak period, more than 2-3. So supposed to travel 60, but traveling 120, 130, but not maintaining the distance. There is no, people talking about the physical distance, social distance. Highly impossible, especially local buses.
Okay. Cannot suggest to go for buses now.
Buses, sir. Yes. Metro, because it's a controlled system. Metro, by taking certain precautions, definitely we can make use of metro system for the present day context.
Okay. Thank you,
sir.
Yeah, please, sir.
Thank you very much, Kumar sir, for enlightening and very informative and technical and also innovative technology you have shown not only in India, all countries you have seen.
All world, throughout world.
World you have seen, you have enjoyed like anything, sir.
Anyway, thank you very much, sir.
Professor Ramana Nayak is telling you, one day we will conduct the seminar, sir, with an association of Usmanian University and Institute of Engineers. Definitely do the transportation, sir. We are facing a lot of problems in metro rail also. Even that parking problem is there, sir. We have to resolve the autobus, all the problem. Problem. We will call the metro rail MD also, sir. We will conduct one day.
Dr. Venus Reddy.
And we will conduct the one day seminar and only transportation with the help of NIT Warangal and also Usmania and also the Institute.
Yes,
sir. Definitely we will do, sir. Definitely very shortly. We will plan it and we will do it, sir. With these few words, really, I am very thankful to you, sir, once again. Now I am requesting our honored secretary, please propose the vote of thanks.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, all of you, for patiently listening.
In fact, we want to give the presentation and all things, but due to the corona, we are unable to give anything, sir.
Not required, sir, because see, satisfaction is very much important. All those things not required, sir. Definitely, I'll take.
I'll handle Kumar, sir.
Please give the big round of applause.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I received the award from the Institute of Engineers. That itself is sufficient.
Kumar sir, also FIE.
You are corporate member, sir.
Sir, I received the Engineer of the Year award in 2018 from Institution of Engineers. So I'm very thankful to the Institution of Engineers, first of all.
Thank you. Congrats, sir. Hearty congrats, Kumar sir. Hearty congrats.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Please respond, Nanjay garu.
Hello, Dr. Garu. Good evening to all.
Good evening, sir.
Respected chief guest, dignitaries on the dais, and our chairman, Dr. G. Rameshwara Garu, and past chairman like Nagbhushan Rao Garu and Satyanarayan Rao Garu, YSN Das Garu, and M. Shyam Prasad Reddy Garu, committee members, past honorary secretaries, fellow fraternities, media friends, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to perform the pleasant duty of proposing vote of thanks. On behalf of the Telangana State Center of IEI, I convey our sincere and profound thanks to Professor M. Kumar, Principal, University College of Engineering, Usmani University, Hyderabad, for making it convenient and gracing the occasion and delivering Engineer G.V. Subbara 4th Endowment Lecture on Urban Transportation Infrastructure Needs and Challenges in India, Indian Cities in a lucid way. Really, you have given a Kumar Saab excellent lecture on roads and with the different varieties, different problems, different convenience and many more, most of the people not even 10% of your lecture, sir. Really, we are very much thankful to you, sir. I convey our thanks to G.V. Subbarao Garu and his family members for making it convenient to participate in today's event. I convey our thanks to guests, budding engineers, and who made it convenient to be with us. I thank the management of media for their continued support and to all our endeavors and activities. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.
Sir, we'll close by Janagana Mana.
Okay.
Janagana Mana Adhinayaka Jayadi Narada Bhagya Vihata Panjaba Sindhu Gujarata Marana Gavira Kundala Vahata
Jai Hind, Jai Telangana. Once again, congrats, Chairman Saab and Dr. Saab and Kumar Saab.
Andarki namaskaram, sir.
Namaste. I'll come by cycle tomorrow, Kumar Saab, to college.